this morning in the Rhode Show kitchen. This is going to be spectacular. We are joined by Chef Tony Abreu, and he is from the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, which is coming up this weekend. Good morning, Tony.
Good morning. How are you?
Good. Great to Good. See you, my friend. We appreciate you being here today. Tell us what we're making.
We're making cacoila.
Not spelled the way you would say that.
Not spelled the way you say it. The C.
Caserta, which is a spicy Portuguese pulled pork.
That's kind of the best way to describe it.
All right, good. Do I win 100 points?
Yeah,
I'll take it. All right, so take us through some of the ingredients that we'll be working here to prepare it.
Okay, so we are using a pork cushion meat, which is that big chunk of meat right there.
Fantastic. What a chunk of meat it is, you know?
Paprika, bay leaves, garlic, which isn't mostly anything Portuguese. Salt, pepper, and that's, we call it crushed red pepper, but it's the wet. Crushed red pepper you can get at any Portuguese store. Onions, sure. wine, olive oil, and more wine.
Fantastic. You never have too much wine. No. I love that. Yeah. And this, of course, this dish, just a small sampling of what will be available this weekend at the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament.
Yeah, we actually sell 13 tons of this stuff the feast. Yeah.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. This is on the small scale what I'm making.
Does it kick off on Friday?
It kicks off tomorrow at 6 o'clock.
Even better.
Yeah.
And you must be tremendously excited. Everybody's working so hard to make it happen.
Yeah, we're coming off a big year. We're coming off our 100th year. This is our 101st, so everybody's kind of kept that energy going through into our second century and trying to keep it as big as last year.
Great. Yeah, well, I hope it'll be even bigger for you this year. And you, sir, will take us through the steps to prepare this
if people want
to tackle it at home.
Yep.
All right. Piece of meat on the counter, pieces of meat behind the counter.
Oh, wow.
What's not to love? Tony, thank you so much.
Oh, no problem.
We will follow your lead all morning long and we'll continue to learn all about, he's a giggler, I like it, the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, which is coming up this weekend and kicks off tomorrow. For now, back over to you.
The Blessed Sacrament is a big event that a lot of people look forward to attending in New Bedford. It starts tomorrow,
Starts tomorrow, 6
Runs o'clock, through the weekend. And it is very exciting time, and something that everyone looks forward to is the food.
It is. So we're making one of our biggest sellers there. Like I said earlier, we sell about at least 13 tons of this. So we're going to start breaking the, I already broke down most of it, the cushion, the pork cushion meat. I like to marinate in the pot I'm going to cook in, just because it seems
easier.
So I kind of throw this all in there.
And this will become our cacoila.
This will become cacoila,
It's about 5 pounds?
It's about 5 pounds. Broke the recipe down a little bit to show on a smaller scale.
Mm-hmm.
We have about half a cup of paprika if you want to throw that in.
Okay.
Just throw it
Dump it all in.
We can do all that garlic.
I love garlic.
Now this is, we call this pimentão moída, which is crushed red pepper, but I don't want you to get it confused with the dry stuff. So they can get by and comes jarred and it's, we call it wet crushed red pepper.
Okay.
You can throw it all in.
Great. Not skimping here.
This particular stuff isn't super spicy. If you get one that's spicier, obviously you can just add less.
Cool.
There's a couple of cups of onions you can throw in there.
Yum. See, cacoila is one of my favorites. And if the Murphys are watching right now, they used to bring it over to our house all the time. It would sit in a nice crock pot. And that's the best part of cacoila. You can kind of just let it sit there.
Mm-hmm.
Let it soak up all of those wonderful flavors.
Yeah, I wanted to say, this is how everybody has a different way of making it. This is just how we make it at the feast. I don't want anybody out there saying, well, my grandmother does this and my grandmother does that. This is how we do it at the feast. So that's why a lot of people call for orange juice. They put cinnamon in it. This is what we do. I just threw in 4 bay leaves and then just a little bit more pepper in it. Just a little bit white pepper. Couple of dashes of salt.
Yum.
And then all of our wine.
Okay. So. All the wine's going in there. Cacoila is well on its way to being complete. And we're going to show you how to finish it and how to eat it later on. Back to you.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen, learning all about the big Feast of the Blessed Sacrament, which kicks off tomorrow. Chef Tony Abreu is here. He's to my left. He's been slaving away, working hard. Tony, we're making the, what are we making today?
Cacoila.
Cacoila.
Yeah, there you go.
I'm learning something. So where are we in the prep process?
So I added the rest of the wine in here. I added a bottle of red, a bottle of white, and about a cup of Madeira.
Okay.
Just to baptize it, I guess.
Sure.
And then, I mean, you want to marinate the quicker you can do it. If you can do it the day before, it's great. And then you just let it sit overnight.
And this is a great thing to make. And if you have people coming over, maybe you've never tackled something like this, you really want to wow your guests. This will delight them.
Yeah. And then you just, I like to marinate right in the pot. And then you just turn this on and let it cook for at least an hour and a half until it falls apart. I have some here that's been cooking and it's pretty well done.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just kind of, you want it till the meat falls apart.
Right.
So it's right about there.
Very, very. I love that bubbling. You know good things are happening. You know it's getting closer to being sampled, of course. How long have you been cooking at the feast?
Well, I've been volunteering at the feast since, I mean, I can't even say volunteering. I grew up at the feast.
Right.
been going there since I was a child. My uncle was the president, so he kind of, every day in the summer, you just went there in the morning with your family and then you left at night.
Sure.
Once you turn 18, then you're able to serve on the committee. So pretty much anyone, when they turn 18, whether you want to or not, you're serving on the committee. So this is actually going to be, next year will be my fourth feast. So I started in 2002, but everybody knows me as growing up there.
Which is great, and that's really what it's all about, that sense of community. People come out, they can experience, you know, the Portuguese culture, even if they're not Portuguese. They've come to know and to look forward to this event every year, that community, haven't they?
Yes, they have. They kind of joke around where they say everybody's Portuguese that weekend. At least everybody in New Bedford.
But when you see, you know, that whole area, the whole block, the whole series of blocks, they're filled up with people enjoying themselves, enjoying not only the food, but the culture. How much pride does that give you and everybody involved?
Oh, it's a tremendous amount of pride. Last year was a big year for us. Everybody served on the committee, but this year I know the committee is very excited to lead off of last year. I know they're very proud. Nelson Ugovedea has done a great job with his committee, and I know that they're extremely proud of what they have planned for the next 4 days.
Sure, and I know last year we were there live. We're going to be there live again starting tomorrow. From an entertainment perspective, there's always lots of things happening. I mean, certainly the food is essential. Everyone looks forward to that, but so many things happen throughout the weekend, right?
There is. We have 4 stages of entertainment. We have our headlining stage, we call stage 1. We have stage 2. 3 and 4, which is all spread out. We have entertainment down at the museum. This year, our big headliner is Candlebox on Thursday.
Oh, that's not bad, actually.
No, yeah. We have Trent Tomlinson, country star, on Sunday, and then in between Friday and Saturday, the stages are going. If the feast is open, there's a stage going.
Right.
So no matter
happening.
What, from the time we open to the time we close, something is going on. We are also a free event, so you don't have to pay to get in.
That's
you can just
great.
Come on in and watch the show.
Enjoy the show. Have something great to eat. What do we need to do here? Is there anything left that I can
assist
you with?
It's very simple. The most hardest part, I guess, is just marinating, cutting the meat and marinating it overnight, and then you just boil it, and it's done. You just boil it till it's done. At the feast, we serve it on pop, so...
Look at how delicious. Again, serve any of this to me?
I'm ready to eat. It's kind of early, but all right, cool. Chunks right now. A lot of people like to break it down more, which you can see it does break down pretty easily. At the feast, we kind of just serve it like this in chunks.
Oh my God, it looks so good. Cannot wait to sample. I'm teeming with anticipation. Come on, let's make it happen, Tony. Yeah. Love that.
You don't want the bay leaf in there, but...
Oh my goodness, it all looks so good. Just a small sampling of many of the delights available at the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament. I'm going to give this a try, nice and hot, right in there. You have to get it very close to the camera, right?
How do you do?
Absolutely delicious.
Good.
Tony, you've done it, my friend. I'm going to have the rest of it a little later.
Oh, there's plenty of it.
It's hot. Well, thank you for joining us.
Oh, no problem. It's a pleasure.
Wish you the best of luck this entire weekend. We will see you there live
tomorrow. We will be there tomorrow.
Thank you for joining us in our kitchen. If you guys would like to learn more about the Feast of the Blessed Sacrament or to get this fine recipe that Chef Tony Abreu just cooked up for us. By the way, look at the shorts. Lift up.
I didn't think you were going to see the bottom part of me.
Shorts right there.
Nice I thought
job,
that was going to be hidden.
Nice job. You can get more information and learn more at roadshow.com.